laid down his sweet head. The stars in the sky looked down where he lay. The little Lord Jesus asleep on the hay. The cattle are lowing, the baby awakes. The little Lord Jesus, no cry.
Christmas from all of us here at ABK Church. We wish you and your loved ones a very merry and very wonderful Christmas. I know this isn't the Christmas that we perhaps expected or we wanted, and today will be hard for so many of us, but I hope and I pray that our worship here this morning as we celebrate Christmas together will give you some joy and hope this day. We're going to have a little call to worship. I'm going to say the first lines that are going to appear on the screen. And if you say back to me the lines that are in bold. This Christmas Day, as we celebrate the wonderful news that God has come to us, that God has come for us, let us go with the shepherds. Let us go to find the Saviour. Let us go with the wise ones. Let us go to find God's promise born for us. Let us go with the poor and the humble. Let us go to find our King, born in a lowly manger. Let us go with all the world, with all the peoples of the nations. Let us worship. Come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord.
Today is Christmas Day. In these past four Sundays, we've been lighting the four red candles. As we move closer to Christmas, as we move towards a time when we truly remember that God has come to us in the person of Jesus. But today is Christmas Day. And so we light the one that stands above them all. We light the one that reminds us that today is Christmas Day. That God is with us. God is here.
Our first song this morning is going to be one that's new to all of us, but it's got a lovely little video. It's called Jesus is with us, and that's the good news of Christmas, that Jesus has come for us. The lyrics are going to appear on the screen, and I hope that you enjoy this video and the song, Jesus is with us.
Mary rides to the busy town of Bethlehem, bears her child, then she lays him in a manger bed. God is born among us.
Christmas Day service, we'd ask all the young people especially, but sometimes the adults as well, what they got for Christmas. We also can't do that here this morning, but perhaps after three, if you want, you could shout into the screen this morning what you got for Christmas. You ready? One, two, three. Well, whatever you got for Christmas this day, whether it was something you expected or whether it was something completely unexpected, whatever it was, I hope that you enjoy those presents as a sign and a symbol of someone's love for you this day. In a moment, we're going to find out about the great gift that God has got for us. But first, we're going to read a little bit from the Bible from Matthew chapter 1.
This is how Jesus, the Messiah, was born. His mother Mary was engaged to be married to Joseph, but before the marriage took place, while she was still a virgin, she became pregnant through the power of the Holy Spirit. Joseph, to whom she was engaged, was a righteous man and did not want to disgrace her publicly, so he decided to break the engagement quietly. As he considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream. "Joseph, son of David," the angel said, "do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child within her was conceived by the Holy Spirit, and she will have a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." All of this occurred to fulfill the Lord's message through his prophets. "Look, the virgin will conceive a child. She will give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel," which means God is with us. When Joseph woke up, he did as the angel of the Lord commanded, and he took Mary as his wife. And when the baby was born, Joseph named him Jesus.
I wonder if you know what your name means. Perhaps you've looked it up, perhaps you've asked someone, or you've explored what your name means. My name is Andrew, and it means strong or manly. And this is Asher, and Asher was born this year. And when Kirsty and I were trying to pick his name, we wanted a name that meant a lot to us. And we found out that Asher means happy. And indeed, Asher does bring Kirsty and I lots of happiness. And indeed, Asher is usually quite happy as well. And so his name definitely fits what it means. And many of us live in the place called Inverbervie. And I wondered what that meant, so I looked it up. And it says Inverbervie just means the end of the River Bervie, or the bit where it meets the sea. And I looked up, well, what does Bervie mean then, of the River Bervie? And it says it means boiling river. Now, I've never paddled or swam in Bervie River, but I don't imagine it's boiling. But somebody named it the Boiling River. But anyway, that's what maybe that's what Inverbervie means, but I wonder what your name means. Well, we find out in the passage we just read that Joseph heard from the angel. And the angel said, Joseph, you're going to name your son Jesus. And there's a really good reason why Joseph was to name him Jesus. Why? Because what his name meant was really, really important. His name meant that God saves. And that's why Jesus came. Jesus came to be someone who saves. He didn't come just as a cute little baby. He didn't come just to be a nice person or to teach us good things. Now, he was those things as well, but he actually came for something far more important. He came to save people. People like me, people like Kirsty, people like Asher as well. In the Bible, we're told the whole way through, from right at the beginning, that God is one day going to send a rescuer, someone who's going to take away all the evil in the world, all the bad stuff in the world, and going to make the world perfect. And we find out at Christmas that Jesus is that promised rescuer, the one who's going to take away all the evil, all the bad stuff, all the sin in the world. And before Jesus goes back into heaven, he tells the very first Christians, the very first folk who might go to church, and he says to them, wherever you go, when you go to school or to work, when you go to meet your friends, wherever you go on holiday, whatever you do, go and take the good news with you. And what's this good news? Well, the good news is that God has come to be our rescuer. God has come to be our friend. Is that even though we had sinned, even though we had broken that perfect relationship with God, Jesus has come to take us by the hand and bring us back to God. We don't really deserve God's love because we've not loved God perfectly. We've not honoured him as we were made to and were born to do. But God didn't want us separated from him forever. And so he sends Jesus into the world. And so Jesus was born at Christmas. He grows up perfectly. Not once did he ever sin or mess up, but rather he lived a perfect life, a life that we all should have done so. And when he was in his 30s or thereabouts, he willingly took our punishment. He took our place. He took my place. He took everyone's place. For 3 days, he lay in the ground, in the tomb. But after 3 days, he was raised back to life by God. Why? To show us that our sins were forgiven if we trust in Jesus. If we believe that Jesus really is our saviour, if we believe that Jesus has taken our place, then Jesus can give us eternal life in heaven. Jesus has come to save. Jesus has come to bring us back to God. Jesus has come so that you and I can be friends with God forever and spend forever with him in heaven, free from all COVID, free from lockdown, free from all the stuff in life that makes us sad and angry and hurt. Jesus, his name means God saves, and he has come to be a saviour. He's here for me and he's here for you. That's what Christmas is all about. We pray this Christmas that you'll trust in him, that you'll know him as your saviour. Amen.
The Christmas story. How would you explain it? How would you picture Christmas if you could frame it?
The Nativity, right?
Shepherds watching their flocks by night. Wise men trekking whilst tracking a sat-nav starlight with Mary and Joseph, humbled by the sight of little baby Jesus tucked in tight.
That's Christmas, right?
propped up with straw and reeds and a tray of animal feed and cushioned in. Hey, I know it sounds quite cosy and nice. Reality was, there was no room for the little guy on that Bethlehem night. He kept in a cradle. Animals as roommates. I'm not trying to pick holes in the state of the place. I'm just saying the way they were staying was just short of space. I mean, talk about entrance. His birth from a dress meant Jesus literally arrived in the mess. But less about the birthplace and the state of the floor. I mean, it's more to the Christmas story than the deck of straw. Flip forward 8 days. In the temple, this little guy's the reason for praise. From the lips of a guy called Sim, who's in his old age. For years, Sim waited in anticipation, but then the old met the new. My eyes have seen your salvation, the newborn Jesus, from messy manger to a passing of the baton just 8 days later. Seeing the mess of the birth comes a new age, and what's more, the birth was foretold in a mess age. Which brings us back to the cast. At the nativity set, you see, it was a message that guided their stable footsteps. An angel postman popped round, said Mary'd found favour, a save the date declaration, you'll give birth to the saviour. He'd be son of the Most High, born through the Spirit, heir to David's throne, his reign without limit to Joseph. Call him Jesus, he really will bless, cause he came to save people from all their mess. To the shepherds, he's here to rescue. That's why he's come. The reason for good news of joy, he's the one. As for the wise men, they figured the news. They gave gifts and paid homage to little King of the Jews. See, God brought the message, so they entered the mess to see Jesus' arrival at the nativity set. But let's back up a sec. See, this rhetoric rings a bell. Back in the day, Isaiah waxed lyrical about a future Emmanuel, God with us, one who'd be central to the story of forgiveness. So zoom out from the Christmas postcard, a message 700 years prior. He'll be a light to the searchers that spread salvation, says Isaiah. See, the angels' news, it wasn't new. In fact, these nativity messages echoed God's promises right through the ages. These messages read Jesus speaking hope to the earth, predicting his arrival centuries before the birth. Thing is, when Christmas comes round, maybe there's a danger that we go Pinterest with Christmas and just pin up the manger in the nativity scene. It's like rating a whole film by watching one scene or thinking you know a novel because you had a quick look. So you get the whole story by skim reading one page in a book. And what I said before, about him born in the mess and the deck out of straw, maybe it could also be a metaphor for all the mistakes, all the messiness in life and what that creates, all the stuff in this world that just doesn't sit right. There was a reason he was born on that first Christmas night. He was born in the mess to make the wrong right. He's the message of hope. Because out of the mess, saw God's new birth that will certainly bless. Frame the stable, sure, but don't miss the picture. It was a message declared since the beginning of Scripture. A war in the mess, but there's only one victor. A heel bruised, but be good news for sure. The very promise became flesh in that deck out of straw. See, from the mess comes a message, and there's none that is higher. Because what follows the mess is I-A-H, mess, I-A.
We're going to pray now, and we're going to ask God to help us to trust in this good news and also to celebrate this good news this Christmas. Let's pray, let's talk to God. Loving God, we thank you for Christmas, for the joy that you have come to us, that you've entered into the world as one of us. We come to adore you on bended knee, with our hearts full of hope and our eyes stretched wide with wonder and awe, that God has come to us to rescue us, to forgive us, to make us part of his amazing worldwide family. Loving God, we pray for everyone in our family and in our community who's needing some hope and comfort today. For all those who are missing their family and their friends, we ask you to surround them with your love. Remind them of the good news, that you are with us, that you are for us, that you've come to bring hope and joy and peace and love to the whole wide world. that for anyone who calls upon your name, there is a fresh start, a new beginning. There is life with you forever. For Jesus is here. Jesus who has come to save. Lord, we thank you for him. And we thank you for all that Christmas means. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Our final song this Christmas is going to be one that I'm sure we love. It's called O Come, All Ye Faithful.
O come, let us adore him. O come, let us adore him. O come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord.
Christmas, whatever your Christmas is going to look like today, and indeed we wish that from all of ABK Church as well. We hope that you do indeed have a wonderful Christmas, and we pray that you'll join us in the next few weeks as we meet online here. And you're very welcome to join us on Sundays at 11 o'clock. Also, our Alpha course is starting soon on Thursday, the 21st of January. We'd love to invite you to that. If you've got youngsters, please do click the link below and use our Messy Church Pack, which is all about Christmas. And you can use that for free to engage with the Christmas story. But whatever your Christmas looks like today, we pray and we hope that you know God's love and God's peace and God's joy with you this Christmas and forevermore. Have a great day. God bless.
Fire in my soul today, everything can change. There's a flame in my heart that'll never grow cold. Today is the Savior's day. Though the path may be covered in virgin white snow, your starlight will guide the way. And the angels are singing, we are not alone. Today is the Savior's day. Tell it all.